For an update on what's happening in Texas, we turn to Joey Palacio of Texas Public Radio. Joey, what's the situation like in San Antonio and more broadly in Texas?
One of the biggest increases we've ever seen in any city happened on Thursday when the city added more than 5,500 new cases of COVID-19 in a single day. Now, that is actually the result of a backlog from a state lab that the city got all at once. Yesterday in San Antonio, we saw 1,100 cases added, and we're seeing over 1,000 cases added in some Texas cities. And there's even been some dispute between the San Antonio Metropolitan Health Department and also the state on different forms of testing.
So there's a discrepancy in what test result constitutes positive in Texas?
Right. So there's two types of tests that are used. One is a molecular test, also known as PCR, and then there are antigen tests. Where the discrepancy is happening is while San Antonio is considering both the molecular and the antigen test in its total test results, the state is only taking the molecular tests. They had to subtract 3,500 cases. And this week also, Texas crossed 300,000 cases. I think we're approaching, if not already over, 320,000 cases. And a lot of this, about half, has happened within the last month. So Texas is seeing a skyrocketing amount of cases.
What's been happening along the Rio Grande Valley, the border towns?
So there's a county called Hidalgo County. On Friday, for instance, there were 450 people who tested positive. And this is a county of about 800,000 people or so. They have 267 deaths in Hidalgo County. Again, its population is around 800,000. Whereas here in Bexar County in San Antonio, we also have about that number of deaths as well, maybe around 240 or so. But we have 2 million people here. And one of the big things to note is that Hidalgo is a heavily Latino community, and we have seen this virus disproportionately affect people of color. It affects the Black community, it affects the Latino community, and so you're seeing a higher number of deaths in a county that is very heavily populated by Latinos.
We're also hearing about a large number of infections of infants.
Yes, so on Friday, Nueces County announced that it was adding 85 infants that have tested positive for COVID-19. And the public health director, she had said that these babies have not celebrated even their first birthday yet. And that's about all the information that we have so far as to these children. So we are starting to see this virus affect very, very young children, even at a point where Texas is debating on reopening schools.
Are people taking this seriously when you're out and you're reporting? Do you see mask usage?
After the cases just started increasing exponentially, the governor put in a statewide mask order for counties that have more than 20 cases of COVID. And you have some folks that aren't comfortable wearing masks. You have some folks that refuse to wear masks. But I've noticed that since it's come back, at least here in San Antonio, that mask wearing has gone way, way, way up just from my own being out and about in some cases.
Joey Palacio from Texas Public Radio, thanks so much for joining us.
Thanks, Hari.